The president will be talking about foreign policy tonight as well, even as events continue to unfold abroad. The Islamic State group released another hostage video today, threatening to kill two Japanese nationals if hundreds of millions of dollars in ransom isn't paid later this week. Jeffrey Brown reports.
And joining me now is author and 21-year CIA veteran Bob Baer. His latest book is called The Perfect Kill, 21 Laws for Assassins. And let's start with the demand for money. If this is, in fact, the first time it's been made so publicly, what do you make of that?
Well, I think the Islamic State is suffering economically. I think they need the money. Its so-called oil sales have run out, especially with the price of oil down. They're embattled. And you know, it's sort of well known in these circles that the French first started paying to get hostages out. The French set a price, and in fact, the hostages were released. Subsequently, various NGOs, nonprofit organizations, also paid ransoms. So there's been a precedent, and the Islamic State needs the money.
In this case, though, clearly no coincidence between the demand for the same amount as the Japanese are giving for non-military aid.
Well, exactly. I mean, I think it's wild that the Japanese have offered this aid to Iraq, most of what they've offered to Iraq, simply because Iraq is in the middle of a civil war between Sunni and Shia, and the Japanese are so loath to get involved in Middle East conflicts, yet they're taking the side of what's essentially the Shia government in Baghdad. So Abe made a clear mistake on this, getting involved, at least in regards to the hostages.
How unusual is it, though, to see IS targeting a country like Japan? Have we seen anything like that?
I have never seen the Islamic State target non-combative states. You know, there may be some NGOs that they picked up that they traded for money, but generally they're after Americans, British citizens, French, anybody who's bombing them. Those are their preferred hostages. So going after the Japanese, there's another side to this, of course, and they probably run out of hostages as well to trade, so they've move down the list to the Japanese.
What do we know about the experience of dealing with or negotiating with IS based on these other examples?
I'm in touch with people who have negotiated with the Islamic State, and they've said, frankly, and these people have dealt with Hamas, Al-Qaeda, right down, and they've been in Somalia for years, and they've never seen a group that is more paranoid. They use the word psychotic, unpredictable, but they did follow through and release the hostages when they were paid money. And they were also, it's interesting, is that the Islamic State is using encrypted email to negotiate. So they're very conscious of not leaving a trail behind.
We heard that from that voice of the IS kidnapper, a familiar voice, I think, with a British accent.
You know, it's Jihadi John. I realize the FBI director has said that they know who it is. On the other hand, I've heard law enforcement people in Washington tell me they still haven't identified him. They're not quite sure. So I'm not quite sure what his true name is, but that's certainly the same accent. And all these hostage takers, by the way, are foreigners. They're mostly Western Europeans. And of course, they'd be able to speak English to the Japanese hostages.
And what do your sources tell you about how organized these kidnappings are and this kind of ransom offers? Individuals, factions, or well organized by a group?
They think that they just belong to they're a wing of the Islamic State. There's no evidence that these people are freelancing it. It's a policy decision made by the supreme leader of the Islamic State, Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi. So they know what they're doing. And for a while, I thought that the Islamic State was on a charm offensive, but that's clearly not true. They are, and I think it's very possible that if these demands aren't met within the next 72 hours, that they will execute them.
And just briefly, finally, I mean, you said that you think they need more money. That would suggest more kidnappings, more ransom.
I think there's probably a lot more kidnappings going on, more than we know. For instance, Iraqis or even Syrians, and these are private negotiations. They're getting money for it. I mean, all the oil income coming out of Iraq is going to the government of Baghdad or the Kurds, and they're up to 4 million barrels. So the Sunni, whether the Islamic State or the tribes in Al-Anbar province, are really feeling an economic pinch, in addition, of course, to the bombings.
All right, Robert Baer, thank you so much.
Thank you.